The Three Monkeys reminds me of see no evil, hear no evil, tell no evil. The biggest evil is not sharing the knowledge of a great book we come across. I stand less guilty today. The reason is Shell, Smart, Happy Entrepreneurs Leadership Library. Thanks for this great opportunity. I shall be reviewing the book Switch, authored by Chip and Dan Heath. One of my all-time favorite book. The book starts with a bang. I have encircled all the inverted eyes on the cover page. There are a few of them. These inverted eyes are definitely steeping the tempo of our expectations from this book. The inverted eyes could mean a lot of curious things in this book. Poses challenge to status quo of what we keep thinking. Get us moving or ahead. Pushing us to turn around the obstacles. Let me put up a disclaimer right in the beginning. This book is not for faint-hearted individuals, as you will run out of all the excuses not to change. Are you wondering who's Chip and who's Dan in this picture? Here you go. The best part of Chip and Dan Heath is that they are having the right inherent combination of being an academician, writer and trainer in them. Moreover, they being brothers had spice and value. All these become right ingredients for making Switch such a fantastic book. You should visit their website. Their website www.heathbrothers.com to read further about them and their other work. On a special note, if you are an entrepreneur looking to make a simple but informative website, visit their website, an exemplary example of simplicity and clarity. In this complex but beautiful world, change is the only thing which is constant. Change is resisted always. Change for good or bad is resisted. For the next few minutes, we shall travel through salient features of this book. It is phenomenal. The book begins with challenging our notions about change. It brings in three surprises right in the beginning. When change is hard, it is important to find the nature or reason of resistance. It is important to break through the resistance. Identifying the right enemy matters. This book makes it easy by metaphorically describing the main influences of resistance as three, namely the rider, the rational mind, the elephant, the subconscious mind, the path. Not just things in the head, but externalities matter too. Once again, the three main influences of resistance are the rider, the rational mind, the elephant, the subconscious mind, the path. Not just things in the head, but externalities matter too. When facing a challenge demanding change, it is crucial to delineate the problem into a rider problem, elephant problem, or path problem, so that necessary solutions can be designed. This book all through describes scenarios, challenges, and solutions based on these three pillars, rider, elephant and path, giving enough to ponder, understand and learn. If you are wondering what is this rider, elephant and path problem, let's take each one of them separately and discuss. The rider is an important part, a part which is conscious, rational and under our control. The challenge is, it is of limited resources. The rider in us is susceptible to exhaustion, hence vulnerable to deviations and wrong decisions. Have you ever noticed to feel mentally exhausted after an important business deliberation? This exhaustion makes you take some poor decisions on diet control, lifestyle, or the whole decision-making process itself. If you are looking to strengthen the rider in yourself or the other person, working on these three steps shall inch you towards success in bringing about the change desired. Identifying the bright spots is extremely useful. When you look into a problem, many a times there are these bright or golden spots where things are happening in desirable manner. These people, systems and interactions which are happening in a desirable manner amongst lots of chaos gives one the opportunity, an opportunity to understand the real insider details and insider clues of what might work. This information is crucial for sculpting success. The rider by default is bound to get confused, distracted and defocused. Scripting the critical moves, the moves which matter, shall ensure that change is attained despite all the plausible fluctuations. Ensure the critical steps are well planned and the rider well informed beforehand, preventing any room for on-the-spot thinking. The rider in us and others has its own ramifications, making the destination or goal clear and concise with no ambiguity increases the possibility of successful change. Moving on to elephant factors. This opens up to the massive potential of the subconscious mind. It is extremely powerful, sometimes can be irrational too. But if misdirected, the challenges faced are insurmountable. The best part of the elephant factors is that they can be motivated and directed in a particular direction. Three main strategies work for getting the elephant motivated. Feelings are powerful. It can make or break the situation. Earlier, it was believed that change happens through the steps of analyze, think, and change. But it has been shown feelings play a major role in change. Now, change is believed to be preceded by the feelings. Making a person change their feelings about a situation or scenario can make them change in a desirable manner. By default, the elephant in an individual is bound to get demotivated and resist change, especially when the change appears massive. Hence, for successful change to happen, shrinking the goal or target is a key. A goal which appears smaller and achievable would motivate the elephant to take the next steps. The elephant in the individual is motivated when it is made to feel a sense of importance, a sense of growth, a sense of respect and love. To get people moving in desired direction, the key is not to make them feel that they are being worked, but actually give them a satisfaction of inherent growth. For change to happen, inherent factors like conscious and subconscious parts of mind are considered important. Of course, they are extremely important, but the external factors or path are not to be neglected. Path does play a role. Moreover, they can be tweaked for desirable results. Path could set the tone for repeated results, helping one to evolve success systems with ongoing results. A change which is not replicable and not sustainable is of no importance. A path of clear environment shall fasten and encourage the possibility of change. Avoiding distractions and deviations in the environment are the keys to achieve change. Pushing a change from one-off event to a sustainable and repeatable habit remains the key. This shall lead to long-term success of change. Ensure that desirable behavior is repeated and recognized. Humans are social animals. For sustainable change, rally the herd or crowd behind the desirable behavior. This ensures successful and sustainable change as their behavior is externally validated. Let me share three things more. First one is relevant for today's world where we are flooded with data and data and data. Many of the information available to us comes under the category of true but useless information. Amongst this pile of TBU, true but useless information, lies the required golden data. Scoop it out and do the needful. Beware of TBU, true but useless information. Great plans without action goes for a toss. To get into consistent action mode, use action triggers. What's an action trigger? Action triggers are actions associated and scheduled after another action, which if performed leads to desirable consequences. Let me give an example to understand action triggers. For example, a person wanting to go for jogging in the morning keeps the jogging shoes next to his or her bed to be worn as the first thing after getting up. This becomes the action trigger. This might increase the possibility of jogging. Just for the fun sake, a better action trigger would be to sleep with the shoes on if possible, so that once we get up in the morning, we are just starting to jog. When you are looking into a chaos or challenge, many times we get absorbed towards the negatives or problems. It is important to learn the skill of appreciative inquiry. In appreciative inquiry, you question not only focusing on problems but also on the brighter spots, the better ones, or the micro successes. This gives an opportunity to dissect into things of what's working. Knowing what's working might help us to find means and methods to replicate in other areas of need. We have used some of this learning from this book in our own organization. Let me share three practical stuff. We strictly follow appointment-based consultations. Reminder SMSs, which we used to send initially, would never be read sometimes or not responded. This would always lead to more confusion whether the person is dropping in or not. We shifted to reminder calls completely. This reduced confusion and increased clarity. Improved appointments at our uni-speciality mental health clinic. Next, in this world of selfies, we realized the power of the word selfie. We developed and executed a public health initiative called Helpy, derived from the word selfie. Helpy is a suicide gatekeeper training program which prevents suicides at community level. This Helpy initiative is able to generate curiosity, increase participation, and moreover remove stigma which surrounds mental health. What else do we need from a public health initiative? The whole idea of naming it Helpy came because of the book Switch. There is a particular case discussed in the book of naming in an interesting way or easy way or a curious way which can bring about changes in a program which is initiated. We have scrapped all the TBU, true but useless information, by making our data collection points like feedbacks, attendance and other relevant documents as single or few touch options, minimizing inputs to the bare minimum. This ensures crucial info is collected with the least efforts and more satisfaction on all sides, overall improving the administration. With this, you've had a glimpse of what Switch can offer. My strong recommendation is learn from this great practical guide all by yourself. Worth the read. The book covers various examples from different fields like business, consulting, technology, health, social entrepreneurship, social drives, behavioral change, etc. So it does not matter what you do, which background you belong to, there is something that Switch can offer. Let's leave behind world a better place. Thank you. Have a great time.